Dead Redemption 2. We have, in the story of Red Dead Redemption, we've come down from the mountains. We were hiding out. We found a new spot. I think it's Horseshoe Ridge. And now we are pretty much through most of the main tutorial. And we ventured off from the camp. So, our little home base. So yeah, Horseshoe Overlook. And we're over here now, and we are gonna go off to as far as we can a west. Get a horse. We have like a, what we call them, a mystery person, something. We'll do that, and then we'll continue. Because my first playthrough, I never actually went and got these mystery appearance things. I know there is a trophy for going through all of those, so I definitely will be doing that this playthrough. I hope everyone had a good Christmas, Hanukkah, and as well, it is now Kwanzaa.
I think I have it.
Hello, mister.
Oh. Hello. Quite a day, isn't it?
Sure.
What a country. I'm working on a project. Photography.
Yeah, I guess that bit.
Of course. Wildlife. That's my thing. Or that's what I want to be my thing. If I have to take another picture of a grumpy housefrau or pompous middle-class burger,
we'll try to do a long playthrough as long as I can go.
Stand here.
And as well, we'll get a Ted Turner biopic in there.
Just
continuation.
There. Albert Mason.
Arthur Morgan.
Pleasure. I'm trying to find and capture images
Albert Corn
of our great predators before our greatest predators. Kill them all and stick them on some clubhouse wall.
Good luck with that.
Yes.
Update his Instagram real quick.
But, well, I love a challenge. The trick is to leave a big load of meat. My bag! That thing is robbing me! Oh, good heavens!
Don't worry. That thing is a coyote. Sneaky one, too. Wildlife photographer. Coming back. Well, well. You got your bag.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, sir.
Bag full of meat will tend to bring out the worst in the local population.
You are a gentleman. The bag also had a lot of my supplies. You've saved me days. Can't thank you enough. Thank you.
Don't worry about it.
You take care, sir.
I ain't the one trying to get myself eaten.
I realize I am a fool. Forgive me. And thank you very much once again.
To attract any wildlife, I'll need some privacy.
Let's go, boy. Sorry, boy. Okay, boy. Yep. Yeah.
something you find interesting. My way of saying thanks. What are my husband's friends talking about? This crazy old woman that lives north of Strawberry stashes weapons for her sons, he said.
Huh.
Anyway, thanks again. I'm gonna get on out of here.
Keep your head down. Don't trust anyone. Now go. Yep. Wasn't my best. No. Thank you.
just don't want him to see me. We're not friends anymore. We're not. They won't forgive you. They didn't forgive me. There is no forgiveness. None, friend. None. I know you want it. I can smell it on me. Well, it ain't happening. No, it isn't. That's why I'm out here, well away from it. They come for me, but I'm like, I never sleep. I never do.
Just gonna lay down, go to sleep. Is that a mission? Whoa. Oh, we can hop up over there. Don't pick up, skin it. And drop.
Ah, no, boy. Nearly done.
Covering.
As long as I can start a fire, I'll never go home.
Right there.
I wonder if traveling with a coachman, you can go through places that you're wanted, needed. get his wanted level up. But I am going to do one thing for that.
Please help me out of here.
Evening, mister.
Now what? Hello? She just freeze? I'm gonna take that horse. Ooh, we should rob his body. Alright, stranger. Oh, that mission failed. I don't know what happened there.
Well, what's eating you, partner?
Eating me?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'll dry up.
What?
See, I'm, Hey, can I ask you a strange question? I mean, it sounds ridiculous, but I'm on the level.
I don't have a clue what you just said.
Well, I'm sorry, sport. There's these funny rock carvings.
He's
they look a
bit
like this.
Kind of guy.
Okay.
Sportsman.
Yeah, well, the thing is, I sort of, like, really badly have to find all of them. Now, it's sort of a puzzle thing to me. I know, it sounds ridiculous, but I'm on the up and up, and it's really important.
Little rock carvings.
Yeah, exactly, little rock carvings.
What do you want to do with it?
Well, it's sort of very complicated, and you'll think I'm jazzed if I tell you.
You're what?
Drunk.
Are you?
No, I wish. No, I'm, lost. It's a long story. Can you find the carvings?
I have no idea.
Well, I sort of need them. Hey, listen. If you find them, I'll pay you handsomely. Send me details, if you can.
Ooh.
Here's my card.
If I can't?
Well, I'm sure you can, sport.
Fancy.
I'm sure you can. Francis Sinclair.
Sportsman. Arthur Morgan.
Pleasure.
But I don't understand, why do you need these things?
Well, I told you. If I told you, you'd think I was on the hooch.
What?
I'm gonna have a lie down. I don't feel very well. And neither would you. With... Yeah, but, hey, what harm could it do?
It is way easier to bump into these random happenings. Rock carving, 0 of 10 pounds. I don't even think I did this in my first playthrough. There's my horse. Where'd the other horse go? Did he go in a ham? Nope, he's still there. Good boy. Oh, it's his bag. Should be bad. Search his saddlebag.
All right, boy.
He's a friend. Yeah. Let's look at the map. So yeah, we're gonna have to go through the wanted territory. So maybe go right here. We'll camp and then do it maybe that night, next night. Poor rat carcass.
Yep.
Haunting rats with my six shooter. Oh, dude, it just ball. Camp here. This is mighty fine. Camp time. Camp Town Racer. Nice, I can do ammo stuff already. Fire arrow? Dang. any other stuff to do recipes yet. So, he's better than doing with the spices. Alright, let's do this bristly fish. Boy, howdy, it's raining. Dinner alive. See how this goes. Right as I enter. He had a mask on, I think. Should have put my mask on to social distance. Great place for Amber. Red Dead. See if it's gonna return me back to the camp. Okay, so it put me back on the other side of Strawberry. This is gonna be tough. How am I gonna... So that's a dead end that way. So I'm gonna have to So right the ridge. I wonder if there's some kind of trail or something. That'll be our goal.
Yep.
Cross through where we're wanted. Yep. Find the path. We're horrible. I'm horrible. Is that one of the viewing spots? There's like spots around the map where the character will like sit. Let's check it out. Ooh. Jump onto my horse from here. That's a wild west. Wild test. Yeah, horse. Wrote it. Oh, when I died, I lost all that stuff, too. On that horse. Dang. That's a bummer.
Yeah.
What?
You, mister, excuse me.
Hello.
Good to see someone who ain't afraid of hard work.
Yeah, well, work's what needs doing.
Get this through the dam and all the way around. Maybe, I don't know. All right. Plan B, water route. All right, here we go. Nice. Okay. That was the first hurdle. Let's see if we can get out of the damned lake. Let's see if we can get down this river to the bay. Back here. is gonna be a huge. I don't think I'm gonna make this one. Whoa!
Great.
Nice, Arthur. Wow. Get it. Yeah. Oh wow, my horse. Hey buddy. Okay, so just go straight through there. Oh wow, we got quite the trail on this canoe. Controller, PlayStation 4 controller is flashing red and white. I'm in trouble. My bounty is $70. It's gonna be hard to get that bounty higher for the chief. Oh wow, they're not pursuing me anymore. Damn, if I can get this to the bay, I think this is our ticket to the west. The Wild Wild West. The Wild Wild West. In the river. Dark. Stay on this side of the... Oh no, don't! Oh no, 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 no! I'm on the bounty side. Oh my gosh. This river. Almost an hour into the live stream. We are on a canoe. The party has made a stop at Horseshoe Ridge? Overlook? Probably not on the map. Okay, not that far. Dangerous game on the west hills of the side. Whoa, what did that red fox do? Yeah. Way to cross, I guess. He doesn't want to get between us and the marshal. Rolling, rolling, rolling on the river. Rolling, rolling, rolling on the river. Howdy. Just trying to be inconspicuous using this canoe down this whole waterway. We made it to the mouth of the river. The delta? Almost there, I can see it. Freedom! Jesus. Hold up, cross it over right here. See if someone's gonna start firing at me. Bounty hunters tracked me down. What the F? Oh my God! There they are! Come on, Arthur! Freedom! Thank you. My canoe is filling up with water. Okay, so we passed all that. We just gotta keep going south. Left a good job in the city, working for a man every night and day, rolling down the river. Okay, I'm gonna pause. I need to get some coffee, some coffee. BRB. Pizza Left Games, we're back. Just got some coffee. Put a little bit of creamer in it. The color is about like a hazel looking coffee. A little in south. Oh, that boat doesn't come get me. I don't want to steal that boat. big, boring canoe ride for us to get all the way past Blackwater. Blackwater is big. West Elizabeth, where Blackwater, we had a robbery gone amok, bank robbery. Dutch, the leader of our posse, and a little cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs, blasted up some people. He normally has a cool head, but he's going a little cray-cray. Arthur Morgan is the well-tempered lackey. He's kind of a lackey, a gooba. But everyone likes him in the group. Right now he's got to go. Arthur Morgan has the need for the sand in the west. Man, look at all of that right there. He came down from the mountains? Oh, what? The boat. No, it did sink. Dead. Wow, where is it going to put us? So a better bet. We might need to find a boat on the other side. I don't know how it got so busted up, unless that's a thing they put in the game that you can't go forward anymore. Make the boat sink. So where am I? Where did it put me? Oh wow, sweet. Alright, so let's just look around the shore for a boat. Continue plan B. Is there a boat back here? There's some fishies. There's some traps for some crawdaddies. Go, Tennessee Walker. a pig. Another canoe. I'm gonna pull this off. Oh, it's a boat rowboat. Got a nice boat now. Yeah. Thanks, buddy. Pal. Oh, sweet. Okay, so now we gotta just creep around the sides. We're all the way through, I think. Bye, horse. What? Why'd you do that? I think there's something in place so you can't get across. I must buy horse. Stuck here. Make a campfire. And let's do the Ted Turner biopic in the sky. Hello, this is the Ted Turner biopic in the sky, page 4. We are going to start Call Me Ted. We're still chapter 1. Here we go. My unhappiness must have been obvious as my parents decided from afar that I should speak. Oh my gosh, this is going to be a tough one today. My unhappiness must have been obvious as my parents decided from afar that I should spend the following school year with my Turner grandparents in rural Mississippi. They lived in a small town of about 200 named Sumner, which later gained infamy as the site of the murder of Emmett Till, the tragic event that helped trigger the civil rights movement. Moving to Sumner meant more transition for me, and while it was hard to leave Ohio, I was thrilled to get out of that awful school and was happy to be back with loving family members on a full-time basis. My time in Mississippi provided constant exposure to nature. Living with my grandparents on the edge of town, I observed all kinds of animals and birds and insects, and they fascinated me. I spent hours fishing off a nearby bridge with a piece of bacon hanging at the end of a string, and I had fun catching turtles. While I was still isolated from my immediate family, and I had plenty of lonely moments, I enjoyed spending so much time in nature, and my memories of this time are mostly positive. My father returned from the war the following year, and our family was finally reunited in Cincinnati. After sending me to public kindergarten in Sumner, for first grade, my parents enrolled me in a private school named La Speech. I was a relentless kid and got in trouble a lot. I didn't do anything really bad, just a lot of little mischievous things like putting pebbles in other kids' galoshes. Today's school would probably jump to the conclusion that I had an attention deficit disorder, but that wasn't the case. After being isolated and alone for so long, I was simply craving attention. My teachers became exasperated. And after just 1 year, they made it clear to my mom and dad that they didn't want me back for a second. This is the Ted Turner bio on The Pick in the Sky, page 4, Call Me Ted, early years, first paragraph. My parents didn't have a lot of money back then, and while it may have been a financial relief to send me to the public school, I'm sure that they were disappointed to have to do it. For the next couple of years, I attended Avondale, a local public school, and my behavior in this new setting was pretty much the same. I caused plenty of mischief, but it was a lot harder to get kicked out of public school than private, and I managed to stay there from my second grade year through the first part of my fifth grade. Second paragraph, page 4. After all the moves and separation of my early years, this was a time of relative stability for me. But that didn't mean that our home life was always smooth sailing. My dad was a complicated man. He was a perfectionist in every aspect of his life, from his dress and overall appearance to the way he conducted his business and raised his family. He was also a deep thinker. He wanted to do the right thing, and he read a lot, including books about parenting. Putting it into practice, all the different approaches he learned about meant that his style was often unpredictable. Page 5, third paragraph. Whoa, horse. One constant in his parenting, however, was a strict discipline and a firm belief in the value of hard work. I was only 8 or 9 years old when my father started making me work during summer vacation. I began at about 4 hours a day, and in those early years, my chief responsibility was working in our yard. We had a man-powered push mower, and if you ever used one, you know how rough they can be. Tough. Let's do the... going back. I began at about 4 hours a day in those early years. My chief responsibility was working in our yard. We had a man-powered push mower, and if you ever used one of... We had a man-powered push mower. And if you ever used one, you know how tough they can be. Every little stick or acorn you'd hit would jam the thing up. And all these ants and chiggers would get you while you want... Well, where chiggers? I have never heard... And all these ants and chiggers would get you while you were down on your hands and knees pulling weeds. I'd be bent over, sweating up a storm, and my friends would come skipping by and say, Ted, you want to go fishing? I hated having to tell them I still had 3 hours more work to do. It was such drudgery that to this day I don't like to do yard work. I might have been out of school, but summertime for me was not a vacation. Okay, so we have 4 more paragraphs, and then the possibly get that one in there, or just keep playing the Red Dead Redemption. So Ted Turner biopic in the sky, page 6, chapter 1, page 6, paragraph 1. I'm a heavy smoker. I didn't know how much of a problem he had with these addictions before the war, but I'm sure his experience in the Pacific had an impact on him. He told me that he loved his time in the Navy, but while he appreciated the opportunity to see places like Australia, he told me that he loved his time in the Navy, but while he appreciated the opportunity to see places like Australia and the Philippines, he also saw combat. He told me that he once killed a Japanese sailor at close range with a pistol. My father and some other guys were looking for souvenirs on a Japanese ship that was half sunk in shallow water in Manila Bay. My father and some other guys were looking for souvenirs on a Japanese ship that was half sunk in shallow water in Manila Bay. Out of nowhere, a starving, crazed man came running out at them. He was screaming and hollering in Japanese and continued to charge my father, so Dad shot him in self-defense. Paragraph 2. But regardless of the reasons, my dad was a volatile man regardless of the reasons, my dad was a volatile man with a quick temper. When he drank, his temper got worse, and when I acted up, he'd spank me. This upset my mother, and I can remember times when I was getting a spanking and my mother stood outside my door, begging my father to stop. Dad would have me cross his knee and say things like, I'm doing this to help you learn to do the right thing and to grow up to be someone we can both be proud of. Oftentimes he'd use a razor strap, and he would say that it hurts him more to beat me than it would if I were hitting him. Paragraph. I had no way of knowing if this was true, but one time when I was only about 6 or 7 years old, he decided he'd prove it to me. I'll never forget it. He handed me the razor strap, lay face down on the bed, and told me to spank him. I tried to obey him, but I couldn't. I loved him so much that I dropped the strap and broke down and cried. Looking back, some of the biggest arguments my parents had concerned his treatment of me, but my dad ran an old-fashioned household, and he insisted that pretty much everything had to be his way. Alright, that was chapter 6. Next to Turner, biopic in the sky, we'll pick up page 7, A Ted Story, Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde, the story told by Lucy Rooney, Ted's aunt. Alright, that was the Ted Turner biopic in the sky. We've been streaming for 1 hour 30 minutes. We just got done with the Ted Turner biopic in the sky. Did, I think, a page or two. And we are failing getting to Blackwater. Or across Blackwater. So let's see here. Maybe we can find a coach and then take it to that one town we visited before. Oh man, we are so far south. Oh, wow. Oh, wait, no. So, we're going to have to cross and try to get there. And then just get on my horse. If we can cross, I don't know. This is a bit weird. Alright, we felled that one. We need our horse, because he's got our rifle. We need to swap out from that bow and arrow. We're going bad boy style. We ain't caring. Rifle. And we'll set a camp. Cook and then eat. Let's eat this one. I think being by the campfire will auto-replenish your vitals, like your Deadeye, health, stamina. Alright, let's cook one more, and then we'll eat it. Get some beard tonic for Arthur Morgan. Give him all ZZ Top. So maybe let's try to find a boat on our side and then just see if it sinks again like last. Man, there we go. Right there. Oh, there's a canoe right there. Perfect. And a little bunny. fast. I'm gonna be right by this guy. Swim across? Stamina, snow, and then an auto. I don't think it'll allow you to go across the water. Then I might have to look into this. I'm gonna pause for a second on this dead. Alright, so those big boats, I wonder if we can get one of those in Saint Denis. Unless there's somewhere where it won't. Turkeys? Yeah, they're just turkeys. I think. Yeah. Eastern wild turkey. So we are just hunting. dying trying to get across to the west. Map. So maybe we gotta go east to the west. Saint Denis ain't that far.
Someone help me! Help! Help! I'm gonna die! Please. I've been bitten by a snake. I need medicine. Why do you need to suck the venom out?
Okay. I have an idea.
Good guy, Malcolm.
Not a word to anyone.
I mean, I owe you one, mister. Hopefully,
I don't want people to know that I'm the rescuing type.
Got that right.
Now, I gotta get out of here. Don't much like it. Out here. No more.
Just stay the hell away from snakes, all right?
Yeah. They're bad. For the horse. So I'm gonna do a can I just go in a circle? Thank you. our way. We coming in this way. Or I could steal a train, maybe. Stealing the train might be a good way to get over to the west as well. Let's try to sell these goods. Many people sent to me. I'm actually choosing to look like that. Oh, can you only give such a kiss?
Will you please leave me in peace? Jesus!
Okay, there's the mission.
What's in your crawl, huh?
Best meat here. Fresh sausages
too.
Hello,
you look hungry.
Pleasure doing business.
Yep.
Out of the damn way.
Let's try the train idea first. Before trying to get one of these weird boats. I'm not a boatman, I'm a horseman. I'm not a bojack, I'm a horseman.
Evening. You been sucking on shine?
Now we're talking. That's out of the way.
Hey, mister.
Parker?
Move next time.
Still the train? What is this? Alright, it's kind of dope.
Who's this then?
Okay, then.
Nice. Okay. Now we got a boat. This is like attempt 3. Early on the game, we're trying to get to the west. So we went to the east by going to St. Denis, picking up one of these steamboats. Let's see if it's gonna kill us. Auto kill. Or he's gonna auto jump out of the boat, probably. Looking for land. And then it died. Are you kidding me? Oh, it just sinks. Weird, there's like an auto unit and it just sinks the boats.
Oh gosh, auto dead. Opening up a pack of gummies. Pack break. Yeah, you're all wet, Arthur Morgan. Dang. Bounty hunters are fast.
Thank you. bounty up, though. Take this till we get out of their area. Kill the people on the train. Any Arthur Morgan train conductor? Red Dead. Two hours in. No viewers. In town? Go do the dominoes. Got a $50 bounty in this town. Dang. Oh snap, dang. $50 bounty for Morgan. Howdy. I'll be right back up. Oh yeah, I should have had my mask on.
Join us here.
This ain't worth nothing.
Where that came from, please. There you go. But it won't get me anything.
Pass me.
Hey, Domino! A welcome I come.
Nice, brother.
Well,
Domino,
you get something from me.
Well, don't think this will help you too much.
I'm gonna leave. Sorry, guys. Sorry, fellas.
Hey, careful now.
Oh, stranger. Okay, yeah, they're strangers.
Doing here?
Sure.
Less than a minute, I promise. We're trying to raise money to build an expansion to the Quincy Harris Memorial Hall, a shelter for homeless veterans and their families. Can you help? A donation of $20 would put us well on our way.
$20 ain't no chicken feed, but sure, I can help you out.
That's very kind. What is your name, sir?
Arthur Morgan.
Your donation will be acknowledged on a founder's plaque when the building is completed. You have a great day, Mr. Morgan.
All right, boy.
Okay, what should we do? We
What should Arthur Morgan do? I'm gonna find where the money is. Let's take one moment. Or nah, let's keep them going. Exploring the era of the area. Fine, sir. Fine dandies. Okay, I'm about to slip out of where my bounty sent to me says. Dead. That was a trap. Red Dead. How many times already? Multiple. A cigarette card.
Okay, boy. Get in. Okay, boy. Let's go.
Looks like we're gonna give her a ride.
Yeah.
Hey, mister, can you help me? Please help me. My damn horse died on me and my legs are hurting and I need to get home.
Be happy to. Get on.
Oh, you kind, mister. If he be so kind and take me to LeGras, that's where I'm from. That's where my people is from.
Sure, that's fine.
Don't normally trust no outside man. No offense, mister. Just don't trust them much.
Right, all right, ma'am. I don't trust them much either.
You seem like a horse rider? Yeah, your whole life, I bet. Horse don't help much in LeGras. Need a horse can swim fine as a duck be much more used to us. Last horse we bucked, got his foot stuck in the mud, gator came and ripped his leg off. The horse just wobbling in the water, another gator came and took the other leg. Then the horse fell and died for a part time, it's gonna come out with a rifle on him. And there's no word of lie.
Easy. You sure it's the horse that's the problem? Maybe you should be worrying about the gators. Where was it? LeGras?
Well, that's not like this. Bet you travel a lot. You a fool. Can't find yourself no home to live and grow and die in if you always moving. Can't build no roots down. Can't grow nothing up. Always moving is no good.
Maybe I don't want roots. How about that? I'm not looking to settle.
We getting close. Don't dawdle now.
Kind
of you being so kind.
Sweet.
Hope I never.
Man. That took us back a bunch. Alright, I think I'm going to take a break on the stream and then come back.
thanks for watching. If you watch this upload, I'm trying to get 50 subscribers in 2021. So if you could subscribe and like the video, that'd help us to our goal of 50 subscribers to Pizza Life. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.